Hello folks, this time we are going to enjoy ourselves for right on an hour, if we wish, on the Falkirk Wheel. It's a bit modern for me, but hey, since we're up in the area, it's almost a requirement. It opened in 2002, 79 foot lift, and this is a rotating wheel carrying boats. Not a lot else to say about it. I just hope you enjoy it. We do have a little bit of excitement in this for you. Yay! They had a fire alarm go off while hanging them out there. So, well, there's something exciting.
Oh, exactly. Enjoy your holiday, enjoy yeah, England.
Right.
And a safe journey back to
Alan.
Another right. Graham, we know lots of Grahams.
Oh, you're lucky.
Thank you.
Good morning, everybody. Did you enjoy that? Introductions first. My name's Jim. I'm your skipper for today. If you look at that and Laura, she's your crew for today. Welcome to Water Vessel Pantomime. Right, before we start, I have to give you a small safety talk. It's not meant to alarm you, it's just a requirement by law. There's six emergency exits on the boat. Two in the centre where you came in, two at the rear where you came in, one at the back that says captain's crew only, and this one here. Clearly marked, this one and the one at the back, captain's crew is secondary exit because it involves steps. The other floor are the primary exits. In the case of an emergency, Laura and myself will get the boat to the side, right, and we'll be the first off. That's to tie the boat up safely. We'll look at the problem. If we can solve the problem, we'll be on the way. If not, and I ask you to evacuate the boat, please do so by the side it's tied up to. The other side is the wet option. If you go in there, you'll come out smelling a canal number 5, not Chanel number 5. And it's easier for us to count you if you're standing along the quayside and bobbing heads in the water. No. Anyway, anybody frightened of heights? No? Nobody frightened of heights? Yeah. You always want. Huh? Anybody frightened of water? No? Yeah? What are you going to do with the boat sink? If the boat sinks, you're a good swimmer. Well, I've got a tip for you, a better tip. If the boat sinks, just remain seated. Because the water outside is 5 feet deep, the boat beneath the water is 4.5 feet deep. So if it does sink, there'll just be a small puddle on the floor. Not that other type of puddle I was told the other day. We're moving in the reverse direction. The wheel can move any direction. If it goes this way, it's reverse. If it goes that way, it's forward. Myself and Lauren, we don't know which way it's going. It just depends on the wheel operator, what hand you've got the coffee cup in, you know? You can see it's going very, very smoothly, right? At the moment, you have 1,800 tonnes of steel, water and boat. Right, and it's only taking 1.5 kilowatts of power to turn it, which works out to an average of 10 pounds, which is two electric showers in a day. So it's very, very cheap. It's because of Archimedes' theory why it's so balanced and easy. This gondola weighs 300 tonnes, 50 tonnes of steel, 250 tonnes of water. This boat weighs 50 tonnes, it's fully laden and now it weighs 50 tonnes, so how come it keeps the same? It's because of Archimedes. Any object placed in water displaces its own weight, so it doesn't matter if it's one boat in here, no boats in the top, or three boats in the top, two boats in here, it will always weigh the same weight, 1,800 tonnes. When we get up to the top, we'll leave the aqueduct, we'll go along the aqueduct, we'll go through Rough Castle Tunnel, which is underneath the Antonine Wall, which is very extensive to the Roman Empire here in 143 AD. If we were a friend in 143 AD, you'd be in Caledonia. When you go through the tunnels, you'd be in Britannia. When we go through there, you'll see the two locks that link the Union Canal that goes all the way to Edinburgh. It's a contour canal. After these two locks, there's no more canals. There's five aqueducts with no more locks. We won't be going there because it takes 11 hours. There's only one toilet and no way of making coffee. So we'll just turn round and come back. When we come back into the top, I'll come back and show you a few sights and answer some questions. I hope you've got lots of questions, because it's nice if you've got lots of questions. When we leave that, there's an audio presentation place. The girl tells you all about the old facts and figures. Doesn't leave me much to talk about it then, so please ask some questions. Okay? Feel free to move about. You don't need to keep in your seat. You can take pictures. Right? If you want to take a picture, you can come up here. I'll open this. This is actually also the Scottish air conditioner, you know?
If you can open.
That's it on. If you want to take pictures, just come up here, put your hand out, take your picture, and then let somebody else in, okay? Please do not put your head out, or your husband, wife, or children, you know, because it's dangerous out there, you know? And there's a camera up there that I need to navigate with, and if you stick your head out there, I can't see where I'm going. All I see is your highlights, dandruff, baldy patches, you know? So please don't go out there, okay? So, have a good time. I'll get back to you after, okay?
If they go astern by accident.
For the next half an hour or so, we'll be up here, 27 meters above our starting point on the Forth and Clyde Canal. We're now moving at 4 miles an hour over the reinforced concrete aqueduct. There's just over 100 meters between here and the tunnel, dead ahead of us. We'll go right through that and turn around before heading back and taking a look at the view that's right behind you now. You might have noticed that there are two tourist boats in service at the Falkirk Wheel, each with slightly strange names. Which one you are on today, when you go on? Those special names were chosen for a reason. They're both important parts of the wheel's identity. First, Archimedes. He was astronomer and mathematician in ancient Greece. He discovered something that's very important for the operation of the wheel.
Any floating object displaces its own weight.
Okay, that might need a bit of explanation. Archimedes' principle says that when an object is placed in water, for example, the boat you are sitting in now, it displaces its exact own weight in water. The amount of water that moves out, weight making for us, is equal in weight to the boat itself. That might sound quite simple, but it's actually really important for the smooth operation of the Falkirk wheel. Gondola, that's the the big tub of water we just travelled up in holds 250 tons of water. When our boat sailed in, we pushed about 60 tons of water. That is the weight of the boat and its fuel and all the people in it. Out meaning that the gondola then had 190 tons of water and 60 tons of boat in it. So, the contents of the gondola still weigh 250 tons. The clever part is that the other gondola will also weigh exactly 250 tons as well. We are evenly balanced with it. And that means that it only takes a tiny bit of energy to get us moving around the central core of the wheel. We're balancing each other out. So while you might think it would take a lot of energy to lift 250 tons of steel, water, books, and even you up the 27 meters we just came, about the same amount of energy boiling 8 electric kettles. That's enough for a cup of tea, each for everyone on the boat. We haven't got time for a cuppa now, but you can get one down at the visitor centre afterwards from the Watching Wheel on Monday end. Another really clever part of the wheel and the cog. You can't see them as they're inside the workings, but these huge jagged wheels and sensors from tipping over as we move up and down around the wheel. When the designers were putting the plans for the Falkirk Wheel together, they were confident it would work on paper, but they weren't exactly sure. This is the first rotating boat lift in the world after all. So to test their theory out, they built a small scale model out of Lego to see how it went. Fortunately, the principle worked and the design was commissioned. Get close to the tunnel ahead, you'll note that we're in a rather charming landscape. At some times of the year, the pool to your left is home to herons. The canal system stretching across Scotland is home to over 30 varieties of aquatic plants, 15 species of moss, over 30 types of water clay, and even freshwater sponges. Plus the ducks and swans. It's been known for fish to swim into the gondola at the bottom and travel up to the Union Canal with us. Of course, they displace their own weight too. And there are footpaths here as well, leading up into the woods. You can walk along these items if you like. Thank you. through the tunnel, you appreciate the views from there, looking out over central Scotland from a scenic vantage point. But for a moment, enjoy the canal site setting. The land around here is stunning and ready for exploration, if you're so inclined. From the visitor centre, there are three walks of different lengths exploring this area, including the remains of the Roman fort and the Antonine Wall. Ask for a map in the visitor centre, or you can hire bikes and make your way 6 kilometres east along the canal path to see the Kelpies. Two majestic 30-metre-high sculptures of horse heads rising out of the water. These Celtic water horses are not only a link with the mystical mythology of Scotland, but are also a reminder of the vast numbers of horses who worked on the canals pulling barges for years on end. Today we run our boats on diesel. Compared to days gone by, it means there's no horseways left by the side of the canal towpath anymore. And we can now travel faster, and in almost all weathers too.
Amazing, isn't it?
If you were thinking of getting one for yourself, you be aware that the price tag comes at a whopping £20 million. We're heading back into the gondola now, so that we can rotate back down to the lower level, 25 metres below. This is a great place to take in the view if the Scottish wind has been kind to us today. You should be able to make out the green truck and the cranes at the Firth of Forth, along with the Othell Hills and various other ranges. Your skipper might point some of these out to you as you descend. As we come to the end of this boat tour, it's impressive to think that the Falkirk Wheel wasn't actually built as a tourist attraction. There was no visitor set here originally, and boat trips like these didn't take place. But people came to visit the wheel out of their own curiosity. They came from all over the world to wonder at this architectural and engineering gem. So we started running boat trips, and the Falkirk Wheel has gone from strength to strength. And now you visited too, and ridden this unique part of the Scottish landscape. Perhaps we should leave the last word for the time being to the wheel's designer, Tony Pendle.
The Falkirk Wheel appears to lift its head and take stock of its Scottish surroundings. It stands up proud and bold, emerging from the land as the skeletal frame of a long-lost great house. It sits on a spine and connects the east and west coast of Scotland and says, Scotland is home once more. The wheel reverberates with the strength and passion, the vision and the imagination that have underpinned the very best of Scottish culture since the 1700s. And, more importantly, it stands as one monument, celebrating the past, but also what may be possible in the future.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Ja, ich hab das Gefühl.
Thank you very much. Hope I can do the same for your video. That's it, folks. If you enjoyed it, I'm very pleased, and you could always subscribe. There's well over 100 on the group. Just need to put in Keith Chasworth and enjoy. Goodbye.